In the summer of 1993, Kim had a worldwide hit with this cover of If I Can't Have You, originally performed by Yvonne Elliman for the soundtrack of the hit movie Saturday Night Fever.
Mandy, and I was sitting talking to my brother about some recordings we were doing, and she came in and she just said, "What a great record, have you ever thought of covering it?" And we thought, no, we had. What a great idea, Mand. Why don't you sort of go and become head of A&R at MCA Records? That'd be a really good idea. So, great idea, Mandy, well done.
Of If I Can't Have You was postponed to the summer because EMI had released a compilation album about the same time MCA had planned to. As a result, the release of the singles collection 1981-1993 had to wait until September. MCA launched a television ad campaign all over the world with a hit album as a result. While in the Netherlands, Kim had lots of fun helping out the band Green Jelly to handle their puppets on stage in the TV program Countdown.
This is my first singles collection, and it's got everything from Kids in America right up to If I Can't Have You, and I'm very proud of it and very excited. It's out now.
And it's one.
Well, first little piggy, while he was kind of hicky, spent most of his days just a dreaming of the city. And then one day, he bought a guitar. He moved to Hollywood to become a star. But living on the farm, he knew nothing of the city. Built his house out of straw, what a pity. Then one day, jamming on some chords, along came the wolf, knocking on his door. Little pig, let me in.
By the hair of my chinny chin chin.
Well, I'm huffing, I'm puffing, I'll blow your house in. Huffing.
And in November, Kim added TV presentation to her already impressive CV. The one-week stint at the Big Breakfast resulted in a stormy relationship with co-presenter Chris Evans.
Give her a plate, we got all week, lads and girls, okay.
I'll be here every day this week for Gabby Roslin.
On the right camera, love.
I'll be here every day.
Back at 8:40, here's Chris and Kim.
Today's question of the day.
Your mum's over there as well.
Is what's the most idiotic mistake you've ever made? Well, ours is that one, now yours. Sarah Bernard.
Stayed in and watched television just as you predicted.
Okay, you know what? You know, Kim finally came with me.
Yeah, well, I heard about that.
She actually turned up, yeah. We had a good time last night, didn't we?
Yeah, we did.
It's quite
great.
A pleasant experience. But I have to say, I did learn a few things about you that I didn't know before.
Like what?
Well, I don't know whether I should say.
Oh!
Well, first of all, I learned that you look even lovelier at night than you do in the
morning.
But then I discovered that you eat less than a rabbit on a diet. And then claim that she doesn't eat less than a rabbit on a diet, she's just having an off day. Yeah?
Yeah.
And I said, why aren't you eating any food? She said, well, I've not had any food all day and it'll make me feel sick. but I also learned that she thinks I'm grumpy in the morning at 5 o'clock.
Yeah.
Bear with a sore head. She had a couple of glasses of champagne, then opened right up and said, oh, you can talk, Mr. Happy. And I went, what? so what did you learn about me?
Well, what did I learn about you? I learned that you like Leo Sayer.
No! And I couldn't put the cassette on.
You put the cassette on, it went... And, and you know, so I didn't have to listen to it, which is a tragedy. And also that you're quite shy, actually. You know, all this stuff like, hi, you know, it'd be breakfast, and here I am, and blah, 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 stuff.
Well, but we had a good time.
Boom, it goes, he's ever so quiet.
Because tomorrow, the World Duck Calling Championship takes place in Maryland, in the United States, which is why we're dressed like this. And Kim and I won't be there, but that doesn't mean we can't have a go, does it,
Kim? No, we can try.
OK, there are ducks on this canal, I'll tell you that. There are ducks.
But I can't see any of them.
No, they're not here, but we do have them. And give it a go, off you go.
OK.
Saying shit on national television also caused a little stir.
Now, Kim, it's not happening.
No,
shall I have a go?
Yeah, you try.
OK. You have a look for me.
OK. Chris, duck!
Where?
On October 25, In My Life was released as a single. It wasn't as successful as the album because the album went gold and platinum in various countries.
I've had a career that's sort of been very up and down, so I don't ever expect great things. If great things happen, then that's fantastic. Like the singles collection's doing so well, and that's great. But I'm equally used to albums not doing so well, so I'm prepared for both. You know, it's like that great quote about if you can look at success and failure for the imposters that they both are, then you might come out sane. So.